Do I need to know data structure algorithms and competitive coding for data science career? When you're talking about data science career, there are four main roles: data analyst, data scientist, data engineer, and machine learning engineer. For data analyst and data scientist role, even if you have basic knowledge of data structure algorithms and competitive coding, it's good enough. Because as a data analyst, or let's say data scientist, you are building a model, you are doing some analytics, but you are not building an enterprise level big software system. So many times I have seen data scientists will build this POC. They will build a model or small Jupyter notebook in dev environment or alpha environment. And once they have proven their story, their data story, they will give the model and their analytics to some software engineers who will then integrate that analytics into enterprise software. Many times they will write, data scientists will write machine learning model, and they will hand over machine learning models to software engineers, and software engineers will integrate them into their big software enterprise system. So the role of data analyst and data scientist is mainly having a domain knowledge. They will look at the given problem, they will come up with some data story, some analytics, some predictive model, and that's it. They present it to stakeholders, and then maybe they write some servers around it, you know, some HTTP servers around the models. But the remaining part, which is integration with main software system, is being done by software engineers. And for this reason, as a data analyst, data scientist, even if you don't have in-depth understanding of competitive coding, data structure algorithm, it is okay. I mean, of course, you're writing code in Python, you need to know about dictionaries and list and some basic data structures. But during the data analyst or data scientist interview, I don't think they will go too much in depth. You know, they might not ask you questions on like binary trees and all kind of crazy data structures. If you're applying for big companies like Amazon, Google, things might be a little complicated, and there, even for data scientist role, they might ask you competitive coding related questions. But this I'm talking about major, like 90% of the companies. Now let's talk about data engineer and machine learning engineer role. What do they do in their day-to-day life? As a machine learning engineer, I have seen in many companies, they will be writing code in C++ or Java. They might be building their own custom models that suits their business needs. And for this reason, these people are building very performant, scalable software systems, and they need to be good software engineer. And whenever we say you need to be good software engineer, which means you need to be really good in data structure, algorithm, and competitive coding. So machine learning engineer and data engineer, they are basically software engineers, but they are working in, as a data engineer, you're working in like Apache, Spark, Hadoop, and all those, you know, big data systems. Whereas a machine learning engineer, you might be working on computer vision or NLP problem, but you might be using C++ or Java as a programming language. They use Python as a programming language too, but they have to be very good, not only in machine learning and statistics, but they need to be a good software engineer. And as I said, a good software engineer means a solid knowledge in data structure, algorithms, and competitive coding. When you know data structures and algorithms in depth, what happens is you can write a very efficient software which performs really well, the kind of software which scales well. Talking about data structures, for example, you want to find, there is a record, you want to find unique elements in it, you have to use set. If you use list, your program will work, but it will not be efficient. Now, if you have a good understanding of what's the difference between list and set data structure, then you can use that sense of judgment and, you know, use the appropriate data structure which makes your program more compact, scalable, and performant. And this is the reason why, as a machine learning engineer or a data engineer, you have to be good in these topics. You can go through various job requirements on machine learning engineer, data scientist, data analyst, and in the qualification, you know, you will find that. sometimes many companies, they say, okay, we have a position for machine learning engineer, but those guys are not really machine learning engineers. They might be doing some one-off analytics, or they might be maybe data scientist. So job descriptions might vary, but all of this I'm telling based on my own 17 years of industry experience. I have been interviewing for last 10 or 12 years so far, and I have interacted with so many people through my YouTube channel who have interviewed and who have got a job. So I hope these tips are giving you some understanding of importance of these topics in various career roles. If you have any other question, please post in a comment below.